everyone. Today I'm going to show you how to edit blurring on canvas in Inkscape 1.3. Basically, you can edit the blur on canvas using the node editor, which is something that we could not do in previous versions. So I've created a scene here of a sunset, and as you'll see, I've already added some objects. These reflections here, they have blurs applied already. This sun does not, but we will be adding a blur to that. So if you select any object in the node editor over here, you'll notice now that there are some new handles added, one vertical, one horizontal. And if we drag any of these, it will edit the blur in that direction only. Now, previously, you couldn't edit blurring on canvas at all. You could only edit it over here in the fill and stroke dialog. But now with this new editor, you can actually edit it directly in either direction individually. I'm going to go ahead and blur these reflections as I want them to be. And this gives you a lot more control than we would have had previously. So you can now get some really cool effects that would not have been possible before. And if you want to rotate the angle of the blur, you can rotate the object itself. And then you can edit in that direction. In most cases, though, I don't think you'll really necessarily want to do that. And you will notice that there is a little bit of a bug, a usability bug, in that when I rotated the object, those handles remained in the rotated position until I exited the node editor and entered again. And the reason that happens is because we're still using a development version, so I'll actually have to report that bug to the developers if it hasn't already been reported. But that's one of the cool things about using open source software, is that we get to actually influence the direction of the development of the program a lot more directly. Alright, so I'm going to select the sun here, and you'll notice that the handles for this ellipse are still the regular handles, which will change the size, or it will change where it actually ends. But if I go ahead and add blurring to this, even just one over here in the blur, you'll notice that new handles are added. Now, basically, because they're so small, they're not going to be very far away from the edges of the object, but you can already edit them on the canvas. So I'm going to drag this one up and then drag this one out a bit. And there you go. Like what you just saw, remember to like, share, and subscribe so you never miss another of my videos.